is that with the players like Apex, Maniac, RPK, can they go toe-to-toe with players like, you know, Dupree, Sipnix, Cajun B? Like, Dupree seen as one of the best riflers in the world. So, really, if we should be looking at this on paper, I think the TSM should be the team to come out ahead.
We're going to find out that answer as we are live into the pistol. Tyne on the CT side, TSM starting out on the T side. And look in the way they're going to go into this. Sipnix, Cajun B, Dupree picking up the armor. And then Cadian and Carrigan going for the smoke and the flashes. I'm looking to see where they're going to execute towards A. They are looking for that mid kind of stack out here and maybe going to do the split towards A we saw last time. And from the start of it, Tyne seem maybe they're keeping an eye on that, stacking up pretty darn close here.
Yeah, they're stacked up really well. Look at B as well. Cajun might be running right into a bit of a trap here because they're stacked up below vents. They're actually right on the edge of it. Existence and Kenny both holding these angles. This is wild. They went rushing up mid, and this could completely catch TSM off guard if they were to go for B, and it does look like it's going to be a B split eventually here. They're making it look like they want to head up to short with Dupree and Sipnix, but they're going to come wrapping around, and there you go, the surprise element. Kenny, he's going to have to step forward and get some kills in. They're just dropping right down, and they don't even see it. Kenny, double headshot for him.
That is the perfect start to slow this one down. All information now gathered. Existence gets run over. The smoke is in place. The bomb should be able to get into position, get that one down. But Apex and RPK now looking for that retake. We saw what that man can achieve with the CZ not too long ago, but straight in. Apex does not mess around. RPK on the cleanup, and now Maniac lurking in the background, waiting for Dupree to show, and they close it down. Tyne really worked themselves into that round. Kenny at the start then. Unreal.
Gotta say that Kenny really just saved their bacon right there. The retake went Titan's way, but then again, you know, they should be able to come in and actually retake on a side if they work well together as a unit. But the main thing is if Kenny and Existence get caught without getting anything, that's TSM's round. It's just gonna be too dominant. They're gonna have a 5-on-3 situation, and Tyne should never be able to retake from there. The fact that Kenny gets two and then dies, that just saves Tyne. That actually gave Tyne a shot. So Kenny just coming in big, and it feels like at least, since the op update, right? You know, we don't get to say that too often about Kenny because he is the driving force behind this team. He's just been struggling mightily with these op changes. So for him to shine in the pistol, that's excellent.
It's certainly going to probably put him in a great mindset as well, getting him feeling comfortable really early on. It's not a bad thing at all. But the T side slowing things down now, looking at what they've got themselves. Two P250s, and that's about it. So if they can make anything out of this, get a couple of guns away, it wouldn't be the end of the world, but it looks like they're going to be stacking up towards that B site. 1 minute left on the board. RPK is holding in on the B bomb site. He does have the SMG, so if these guys get close with Existence watching the cross, getting those tags in very early, this is going to be a very painful round, and Tyne keeping it pretty darn clean. Only Cajun B picking up one, but Cajun B picking up two then, finally going down, but Sipnix now in a pretty tough situation, gets picked up. No bomb plant either. And TSM, that was pretty clean all in all. Not the worst in the world for him.
And look at RPK's money right now. Three SMG kills. The rest of his team are floating around 3,000. He's sitting on 5,100. But those three right there, this control from him, the fact that he picks up those three frags, he nearly got a fourth as well. If that was pre-nerf on the CZ swap time, RPK, he was just like, guys, I got it. I don't need your help. Thank you very much. You know, just trust in me to land the headshots.
Looking at this. T-side going to get themselves pretty much forced into this, a couple of AKs, two Galils, Tech 9. They do have the Molly on Cadian, so clearly got something in mind to work through towards this round. We've yet to see them play towards A. Two plays towards B. First round was kind of through mid, and we saw what happened with Kenny. But Kenny, yes, feeling confident, going for the opening shot there. Down by Squeaky, not going to find it, but at least catches a glimpse of one.
Yeah, and confidence is the key word. Kenny has to establish that right now because he hasn't had too much of it since this recent nerf. So he feels like his style really got impacted, that he's been struggling mightily since the change has been made to just find a new way to use the op. And he feels halfway decent on CT. So for him to go ahead and try and get those aggressive scope peaks like that, I think it's only because it's in Squeak, and he's kind of hard to pick out there, so maybe that split second of difference of being able to spot him out, that's why he goes for that kind of peek in particular.
Let's see if RPK can do just as good with the M4 this time. Brilliant pop flash comes over the top, and this is just decimation. Apex comes in to just assist more than anything, but Cajun B, he's been doing damage in the background, but sadly not enough for them as the three players from the CT side close it out in the end, but RPK this tournament has been pivotal in what they've been doing. Whether I look back to Inferno when I was casting with you, these guys, he was huge in that. And now he's showing once again he is just really damn solid, especially with Apex there with him.
We're missing one of the key parts here for TSM, what goes into the recipe for victory for this team, and that's Dupree. And that's Dupree getting a strong start, getting kills off the bat. Doesn't matter if it's Ecos, pistols, whatever. This man needs to get gets kills on the scoreboard. Otherwise, he starts to flounder. He's really a confidence player. Just so, it's so important for him because he can tilt. If he starts looking at that scoreboard and doesn't see anything listed, it's harder and harder for him to get his head in the game and to start performing. And TSM really do need to rely on him, especially without Device being here. It's that double combination.
Well, let's see what we can get out of KGB and KD. Now that was beautiful, just railing existence down. And RPK gonna have to do what we've seen him pull off before. This 2v1, but pistols all with the T side. Agent already on three. Kadian holding the angle of the back, gonna spot him out first. Call comes through, Cajun B perfectly adjusting round. And that was just lovely synergy between the two standing players and individual genius from Cajun B.
I'm squinting up my eyes here because I'm just like, how in blazes did Cajun B just get a quad kill with a Deagle? Like the one pistol where it's like, you know, good on you for buying it, but you did kind of just throw 700 bucks out the window that you're not going to get back. And Cajun's like, well, okay then, here, let me demonstrate how to wreck people's hopes and dreams real quick for you. Thank you very much, Cajun. And I was going on and on talking about something. Like, you know, I guess I like went back to a year ago when pistols weren't nearly as lethal. But there you go. Cajun B just coming in big, and now TSM are on the board, and that's actually put Titan on the back foot. We see kind of mixed buy coming out from them here, and that is actually them kind of evening out their money, but not really.
Yeah, not exactly a brilliant start. And Kenny S was the one who got, I think, initially picked up by that Deagle work coming out of A main, but this time not fancying it. Two smokes being placed down for the T's over by A. A quick push over towards B, but RPK is waiting. The CZ finds one. That's 2-3 down. He's been locked out of this game, but there's still players waiting to pick up that mantle and carry on running. Apex might catch a glimpse of him crossing. I don't think the bomb's quite there to sight yet, but the smoke coming off of that molly might just really put him to the test. But still, three players to retake this. They can still get into this one.
Kenny's got an AK. Kenny has picked up an AK now. Great nade onto him there. That's going to drop him down to 50 HP. They lose Apex and CT as well, so this is actually looking fairly solid here for TSM. They just need to play from the sights. They just need to hold, and Cajun B takes out Maniac, who was trying to push upper. Kenny now the only man left here for Titan, and TSM are doing the right thing. They're just sitting. They're waiting. They're playing the bomb. He is lurking in B halls, though, but now they know. And now Kenny can actually try and turn this into a situation where he just tries to hold them onto the site, trying to buy as much time as possible to make them go up with that bomb. But he decides he wants to hold on to that AK instead. He's going to get value from that. And considering the money right now for Titan, that's not a bad choice. 37.50. He can have an AK to work with in the next round.
Yeah, putting himself just in a better position going forward. And as you said, with TSM playing that calmly on the site, literally just locking it down, you know, that was pretty much the best shot available to him. The rest of his team still kind of struggling, as you mentioned, not having the best of economies building just yet. And you can see it there, two CZs, one with Apex, one with RPK. Those two did do well on Inferno when we look back at their B-hold when they're locking that down together. But the rest now need to find some sort of form here, because it looks like the T-side is starting to build that confidence here. A nice little boost up coming out. Maniac going to sit up there. I don't think they saw him get up there either.
They should assume that Maniac is there, though, because he always plays this position. Always plays this position at least once on cash. So you have to go for him. You have to check upper. You do not run out here without looking to your right. You do not run out here without looking to your right. And there you go. Maniac gets two kills. He gets a little greedy and steps forward. Kadian will take him out. That was a big mistake there by TSM.
Huge mistake coming through. Thankfully, though, they've got the likes of Dupree finally finding that bit of form, even just taking down these players on time who were on eco. But still, existence last one in this 1v2. Bomb yet to go down. You can see it will be Carrigan to put that one on site. Kadian should be able to hold the angle. He does, and it's going to be 3-3. But as you said, was that just a little bit of, you know, not checking your corners when you need to? Is that something that surely would be in TSM's mind normally, or is it, what do you think caused that? Because you'd assume they'd know, right?
Well, yeah, everybody should know this, because Maniac is one of those players. He's very predictable in where he wants to hold on CT side. So like Inferno CT side, for example, he's always on balcony over pit every time. So it really should become second nature now for teams on T when they're playing versus Titan. You just check these spots. You should be just checking these spots to make sure, because that could be a free pick every time.
Seventh round now in, 3-3 here. Another one on the buy, at least for both teams. Maybe not ideal. Kenny not getting the armor there with the AWP, but already taken out of 42. But it looks like Apex is going to get himself a little touch closer towards B, and to be fair, it seems like the right idea right now.
I like an Apex's position, however. They do have three on B right now, though, so I mean, that could have been perfect for Titan had TSM committed. They could have got completely caught off guard there, the Danes. Instead, they decide to slow down their pace somewhat. I mean, they are a man down, so this is natural at this point. They need to try and find a pick to bring it back. Titan are playing this fairly well. Existence and RPK holding on the side. RPK is going to get caught out in the open, but Cajun not able to connect. Didn't look like he was quite on point there with his crosshair placement.
Yeah, just a touch out. Now, Cajun B has been instrumental in how much TSM have built. And look at Apex. He's just on the cusp of being able to see these T players starting to build. He's going to go just as they see that smoke starting to be played. Kadian deals with him, one for one exchange, some information gathered, but the T side not really committing off the back of this.
Just taking too long. They are going to try and go for a split up short, and there you go, Kerrigan creating the opening. Do they have the time though? 20 seconds, 20 seconds to get in there and get that bomb plant. It looks like they can just manage it. 8 seconds, it's going to be close. Kerrigan has to stop this man on CT. He's going to go for the wild spray and take out Kenny. Cajun from the backside is actually going to catch out Existence, and just like that, what a call from TSM, and what a play from Kerrigan in the lurk role, catching out that rotator and basically gifting his team that bomb site.
Yeah, and RBK isn't going for this one either. Kerrigan, the man who was pretty much untouchable in the previous game we got to witness, finding a little bit of that magic again then as Kerrigan goes hunting a little more for RBK. And RBK will find that one. Kerrigan just pushing out, trying to get that AWP away. It looks like we will be seeing just a nicely done round from TSM in the end. And that was all off the back of what Kerrigan created then.
Yeah, that was, I mean, him being able to catch that and then make the call. But also the fact that TSM didn't commit, they could have potentially tried to run in once they found Apex, because then perhaps you can think, well, you know,
there's one
guy on the site and there's one guy up in vents and checkered, right? And that's the B defense right there. But the fact that they held back, but one thing that we didn't get to see on the stream was whether Cajun spotted out the second man on that side, because we saw him spot the first, but did he spot a second, and did he realize, wait, that's two different people? Maybe that could have been the call right there, that TSM was like, okay, wait, we just killed the guy coming from A. That means that bomb site, you know, we know where the rest of them are. So really nicely done there by TSM. Just on the fly kind of call that really pays off.
It's looking good for this one. 4-3 so far. TSM just about taking the lead, and Cajun B denying Kenny, and the AWP is now down. That's got to do just... got to shatter Kenny Essex.
Exactly. And if there's any, Kenny is going to be one of the weaker points on this team as far as, you know, the mental strength, because he's already under pressure. He already feels like he's under attack personally, because his play style has been just thoroughly nerfed. And now him trying to make old peaks work, he gets slapped down. It's going to be really hard for Kenny to get his mind in the game.
And I love this. I'm pretty sure Cajun B just picked up Kenny's AWP, trying to make sure no other members of Titan can get hold of it. And now just holding to see if they come out hunting for that. Really smart stuff from Cajun B. Obviously, something to be expected of a man of this caliber, but the rest of the T-side still need to look at closing this round out. There's still a hell of a lot of players standing for Titan, and they're just getting themselves ready towards A, but look at this. It's time to hit these rotates. They're starting to get real fluid with their game type, and I'm loving this from TSM. Not yet committing. 36 seconds. They could still get caught out here, and Maniac getting a little aggressive, challenging down Kerrigan. Apex doing the same from Squeaky. They've got the information, but I don't know what they can do with it.
Apex should be toast. He should never make it out of Squeak alive. They should be able to just hunt him down now, but he still takes out Kerrigan. Nice lurk by Kadian. He gets the double spray just barely, but Apex somehow has actually turned this around. He's gonna catch a man out, and Cajun there is luckily in position to save Dupree's life. Way too close. But when they knew that Apex is actually in Squeak like that, I'm wondering if they actually tried to open the door, because it could have been that peekaboo moment like in Aliens or something. You know, the door opens, there's the alien, of course, and Apex, he's got a CZ that shoots out of his face and just impales you. Like, that might have happened right there. We didn't get to see it.
And luckily, in the end, he actually ran out of bullets available in that CZ. It was literally down to zero. Just he was getting that last little bit of a spray on. He might even hit that if the savior didn't come into place. But still, 5-3. Cajun B still with that AWP, picking up Kenny's that you saw there last time. Kenny has got himself back to an AWP at least, so we're going to see Titan back on this buy. Still not ideal, but certainly probably one of the better ones we've seen them able to scrape together here. A couple of mollies, still a couple of smokes to be played out. And TSM really slowing down their gameplay here. I kind of like it. Waiting for these picks to come, and then their rotates have been absolutely everywhere. We've seen several times they're just waiting for the moment and reading the game so well, considering they have that additional player. I think you were spot on at the start saying TSM respond really well to being on the T side, and we know the Titan have occasionally struggled on their CT. This is surely going to be worrying Titan in the back of their minds if they don't find that little bit of form.
Cajun spotted out Maniac, or Apex rather, on short. Maniac rotates back around. But yeah, that is the big thing. I think it's all about confidence right now, and TSM are confident in their ability to beat anybody on Titan in a straight up fight. Although Apex is interested in, you know, basically teaching Kerrigan otherwise. A lot of this is based off of, you know, we're going to play for picks, we're going to catch Titan getting to antsy, and we're going to punish them when they do. Although right now, Titan are playing this very well. They're going for the rotate over. There's only 25 seconds left, and TSM are going to have to commit. But there's a very clever position here, actually, and Apex already drawing the attention to himself.
Apex as an individual has been outstanding, but Dupree and Cajun have still got their eyes on that B side. Cajun, the only one to be left standing in this, has to deal with Kenny, who misses the shot on the cross. And Maniac, still pretty far away. He's made it over towards Checkers. Molly comes in. I think it's just behind Cage and Beaver. Will go down. My God, he was lucky to not get burned alive then. But still, Maniac was there waiting for the cross out. They'll pick it up. They'll retake it. That felt pretty darn close. And I think we've got to say Apex once again. He's been just a huge player. That pickup in mid, that play coming in from heaven, just peeking up that beautiful shot there.
I just love
it. You're loving that molly.
I'm just thinking, you know, it's too hot in the hot tub. Gotta get out. Gotta get out. And then, of course, you get shot when you do, you know, so it's just this lose-lose situation. Either you turn into a lobster or what gets shot? What gets shot? You turn into a pheasant. You know, there you go. Or maybe a turkey. Does Cajun look like a turkey, Panzer?
No, I'm not saying anything about this, you know.
He's got those tattoos and everything, man. Yeah? He looks rough. He's gonna mess you up.
Dude, that's why I'm not saying anything. You know, I'm terrified now. You put me on tilt, let alone the rest of these guys. But look what you've got in this. I don't know. I'm just seeing TSM looking like they're leading the complete pace in this game. Don't get me wrong, the scoreline is close, and Kenny S doing that is going to work wonders, but nice little pop flash going to allow Cadian a step in, but not too far, as Maniac denies that even a chance towards it. He's got the bomb right next to him. This should be a round for Titan, but what's just gone on here? Zipnix and Kerrigan having none of it. Going to keep going. And now Zipnix already picking up two. He's still got two more to find in this one. Kenny just holding that cross. They know where the bomb is.
Exactly.
And Zipnix is going to be struggling to do anything here, but they're both pretty darn close together.
Unfortunately, there's no gear near him. Do they really peek him? Okay, that is like insanely risky. There's absolutely no reason to peek him at that point. That's a wild gamble, because what he has an AK. You come around that corner, Zipnix pulls the trigger, he takes your face off, and then you're leaving it in a 1v1 scenario. And then it's almost a gamble if Kenny, you know, Kenny with an AWP, he has that angle to hold. I mean, it could go either way. But Titan decide to play the power play. They go for the power play instead, and just beat Zipnix up. So 5-5 the score, and TSM, they do manage to cobble together a buy here.
Yeah, somewhat of one. Two Tech Nines still in play. Cadian and Kerrigan, everybody. Holding on towards those, and Kenny's starting to look for that confident pick again. Pushing up, dangerous against these Tech Nines, and it's actually Dupree who's holding the angle. So all the players with the AK, and Kenny's going to get denied so early on.
This is perfect for TSM. They really are going to be able to tilt Kenny if this keeps up, if he keeps getting shut down on his peaks.
And I love that. Dupree knew what was up. As soon as he did it once, he was there just waiting to see if it happened again, and he was on that perfect spot. So 3v2 onto this A site at least if they make the play now. RPK and Existence are still pretty far out. Smoke and nades coming, quad green challenge down. That's Apex actually this time who's stuck there, as Maniac holding so close. And Maniac once again doing the double, doing that dirty work. But Cajun B, the last one to really do some damage back to them. But it's a 3v2. The bomb again in this awkward predicament, but at least they've not got a player too close just yet.
Miscommunication as well between these two players. They use two smokes on the same position right there. That's actually a crucial error made by TSM. Now can they actually get their hands on that bomb? It looks like they have picked it up. It's going to be on Zipnix. Holds close, and Apex is ready. Takes out Cajun instantly, and then Zipnix 1v3. Not a whole lot he can hope to get done in that position. RPK will shut him down. You can see maybe some nerves there from TSM. Both of them using once, like, they had two smokes. They could have used that in a different way. They could have used that to block off quad boxes at the back of the site instead, or in then NCT, right, or somewhere. But they use them on the same spot. So that's wasted resources there. Well, at the same time, TSM have still got five rounds on T side, so they shouldn't be feeling, you know, they shouldn't be showing nerves. They should be feeling like they've still got this under control.
Yeah, it's a curious thing. Maybe just a little bit of a rush decision, as you said, something that just, you know, held them back a little bit. But regardless, it's going to push the T side down now to just a bit of an eco. P250 there on pretty much everyone left alive, but not a single chance to use it so far. And Kenny just holding back firm. Maniac again being pretty much a pillar of solidarity on towards that A site. Kenny being very quiet so far. And Dupree just dancing with Maniac on towards short. Not going to get anything out of it. Very clean round for Titan, not losing a single person. Getting a little low, but holding all their guns, holding onto a lot of their arsenal. And now they're fully sorted.
I'm just picturing Maniac every time he goes like that. I'm just like, yeah, man. And then they walked into my crosshairs and I held mouse one. It was fantastic. Like, it was perfect. It was perfect. See what I'm doing? Perfect.
I love it.
I mean, Titan right now, they've got to be feeling pretty perfect. I mean, Kenny's got enough money for an AWP again. TSM have one on Cajun, though, so we're going to get to see that battle once again. We'll see who wins out. Cadian last time didn't have too much luck. I think he got shot out by Apex over here. So he's got to be a little bit careful in the squeak area. But we see them actually setting up here, Longhouse. Zipnix just making sure that they can't go for any kind of crazy push. That's one thing the Titan really haven't been doing, apart from Kenny, who they give free reign to do that. It is Kenny's role to push around and do what he wants on the map. As for the rest of the members, however, they have been playing fairly passive. No counter boosts in mid, no real risks, you know, taken as far as pushing into B halls or pushing A main. Titan are really just counting on the fact that when the time comes, they'll make the right call and then they'll land the shots.
It's dangerous to be keeping yourself in that sort of mindset. And looking at Kenny's performance so far, throwing our minds back, last time he hit 26 kills. Sadly for Dupree, not going to get too far there, but this time, I think he's around 4 or 5. So he was top bragging, leading the board. And on the other side of things, the opposition, Cajun B right here, he wasn't far off either, down on 18. So last time, that battle was certainly in Titan's favor, but so far, a little bit different. But nice build-up coming out from the T side, kind of pushing and keeping them at B. But the main player is coming down towards A. Everyone else is working towards A. Kenny and Submania are going to have to hold this.
Yeah, they are going to hold it as well, because Apex on high, he's spotting into B halls. He doesn't see anybody there, so they know, and they hold solid. Kenny dancing around quad boxes, doing the best that he can here on the edge of the Molotov. He can't back up. He might burn alive. He's stuck in this position, but it makes it work. Maniac and Kenny, and again, Maniac, they run into him. He just sprays him down with the FAMAS. Kenny, you know, as an afterthought, picks up the last kill. And that was also very good work there and very good information given by Apex, because as soon as you see those two guys in checkered there, Titan might be going, whoa, we gotta start rotating. Maybe they're gonna come here. But Apex on high, he's looking into B halls the entire time and he sees nobody. So he's just thinking, well, hold on guys, be patient. We haven't seen the bomb yet. We don't know where they're coming from. Great play by Maniac and Kenny to just hold solid on that A site.
Yeah, showing how calm these guys can be, how much intellect goes into every single angle they're holding, and it, as you said, worked out well for them. However, TSM now, once again, this kind of jumbled together by these two Tech Nines, and KGB is one of the players who did have the AK. RPK goes down. This time, Apex is nowhere near the B site. Kenny S does get the glimpse across. He spots maybe one crossing, but I'm not too sure if he got a full shot then at it. These flashes come in, the mollies break them down, and T-side have fully got this site under control. They have two flashes left to hold it, every single player alive. This is looking good.
Yeah, this is actually a very solid position for them to be in. Kerrigan, not sure if he's picked up that there's a man in vents yet, but Sipnix has taken out existence in the meantime. He sees the nade coming, he now knows. Maniac with the flash, Kerrigan turns away. Does he win the battle? No, he does not. Maniac will overpower him. Instead, it's Dupree with the crossfire along with Cajun B, and it's going to be into a 2-on-1, and Kenny just can't pull it off this time. TSM with the change of pace. Instead of playing that slow, composed, look for the pick kind of battle, they're like, okay, the time is right to just go crashing into the defense, catch them off guard, because we've taught them now that we're gonna play slow. So let's go ahead and change it up and just go for a full out YOLO rush onto B. And it totally works.
I love it. It just completely cut off anyone to support RPK. You saw that Apex was still nowhere close to be on helping. Existence was locked out by CT. This time they're pushing straight in towards that side, trying to get that setup they had before, but you know, TSM, as you said, they switched up for that. They made that different play, so they've got so many options now available to them. 6 rounds on the T side. How are they going to close this out? This could be dangerous for Titan.
Let's not forget that we're talking about a Danish lineup here. They're the kings of CT. So 6 rounds, that's actually very good for them to have that so many rounds to work with now on their T side. If they can pick up a 7th here, that would just be just brilliant. TSM would be looking in fine shape. All of the pressure now is on Titan. And we can see that because they go for a bit of a gamble, but then Apex is going to rotate back into mid to hold that mid connector. And they're going for just, you know, standard 2-1-2. Titan are just looking for a bit of a catch-all approach here, and they're playing very, very carefully. They aren't peeking, they aren't showing anything. They're playing blind, and this really scares me, because TSM, if they were to go as 5 onto a site, that's going to give them so little time to react.
The overmatch just for these T players is huge. Wherever they decide to go, they just seem so confident wherever they are. They've got a plan onto this one, but here comes a push. Nice play from Maniac, getting a little aggressive there, finds Cadian, but quickly shot down. But where are the T side going to head? It's going to be a molly to quad. We're going to see Apex already ready and waiting. This is surely the perfect opportunity. Gets 2, denies the cross out. Kenny holds it down with Kerrigan pushing in. And now Cajun B 1v3 shouldn't have a chance in this. They're a little far back. The bomb is not in his hands either. With 15 seconds, it's not going to work out. Titan closes it out at a 9-6 on the half. But as you were saying, 6 rounds on the T side, still pretty impressive. But in your opinion then, who was more pivotal in this one? You've got Apex being pretty much everywhere at the right time for Titan when they won these rounds, and Maniac being pretty damn solid. Those two have been hugely instrumental in this.
Apex is playing the key role right now on the Titan defense. He's playing that rotator role. And that's a lot of it is to do with feel. Perhaps Existence is giving him some guidance as far as, you know, what the information, like what information is getting fed back into Existence.
Jesus.
He's the one who's saying. But yeah, right now it's the Cajun B show. But like Apex, yeah, I mean, past few rounds, he's been in the right place at the right time. You can see the impact there. That also comes down to Titan just making the right call. When you're going to play that far back, you need to make the right decision and then you need to land the shots. And Apex has been making, well, both of those happen.
This is massive. 6 rounds for TSM. Let's see if they can make it to 7. The T side this time will be Titan, starting out with a Tech 9 up on RPK, Maniac hitting up the armor, but everyone else going for the smokes and the flashes and Existence dropping that one over towards RPK, I can imagine. A P250 for himself, actually, but you are seeing something we've seen before, this kind of squeaky presence going up in time, but will they actually push it? Because look at this pre-fire, Cajun B just going to stand there, clicking away, waiting for it, as Zipnik's already set up with Kadian in the crossfire. They're going to clean house right now. Existence is nowhere to be found. He was lurking in the back, holding that push around the backside, but no one came, and now he's left in a 1v4 with very little hope here.
No, he's in a very dire straits. 1v4 and no Kevlar. Can't really take a long, drawn-out fight. Cajun will end up getting two frags in the round. Kadian and Zipnik's also doing a fine job locking down that A site, but that's a bit unfortunate there for Titan because it's also a bit of a gamble for TSM. You saw that the setup that they went for really favored A. They had three guys holding solid on the site. They had Kerrigan waiting in connector so he can rotate over very quickly, and then they left Dupree all by his lonesome over there to, I don't know, pick flowers or something on the B site. So Titan really just kind of ran right into where TSM wanted them to go.
And you can see them just forcing themselves with everything they can. Again, Tech9's all across the board, barring the likes of Maniac and Existence, who are going in for those P250s. A hell of a lot of smoke, so looking at it.
That's a fine pistol you have there, Maniac, thank you.
It's beautiful. Dupree getting aggressive, though. Gonna try and get the information early. Caught a glimpse of two, but didn't really get anything else out of it and losing out to that gun. I don't think they actually picked it up, though. That's still in place, and KGB gonna be keeping his eyes on that one. And the T side, once again, we're seeing these guys starting to play a little slower, a little calmer. Looking to maybe just draw out TSM, hope that they go to those wrong sites, force them to play these unideal situations. But we're going to start seeing those smokes being put into place, and maybe that playthrough mid to A will kick in pretty darn soon. And Gideon catching a bit of a glimpse there for himself. Maniac starts to make his presence known through Squeaky. Molly goes down, but the rest of the players starting to fold up towards Short. Kenny does take down Gideon, but as Zipnik spinning left, right, center, does get the tag towards Maniac, but he needs more up above, waiting on towards the rafters there. Cajun B's nades will take down Kenny as a Maniac now. Disastrous spot here. They had such potential then on the side to do some damage, but Zipnik's hold on. And well, for TSM, it seemed like it was on the cusp of losing for a couple of seconds, and then they just locked it down.
Yeah, but it's also timing there for Kadian to peek into A main and get the info that they needed. That worked out really well. Titan, okay, the initial frag on Dupree happened so early that really there's not a whole lot that TSM can do apart from rotate an extra man to B because they don't know. It's too early in the round. Titan could be going anywhere still. So the fact that they hit that timing just perfect when they need to get info, they're like, okay, well, we kind of need to figure out where the hell they're coming from. And Kadian takes that peek, sees them coming, lets them actually fall back onto the site and defend properly.
This is sheer confidence and aggression, and why not?
Well, this is just like, hey, well, I'm gonna bully you a little bit. You know, your feelings, what are those? Oh yeah, that's what I had to scrape off from under my boot. Like, that's what Dupree is telling them right now.
I think they're gonna start feeling that too after three of them going down to it. No armor board up, no nothing.
Let's continue to feed the MP7, which is giving him $600 per kill. That sounds like a great idea. Actually, let's give him four kills. That's so much money.
Look at that.
That's so much money.
Oh my word.
Just go and die to an M4. Better yet, find the guy with the CZ or the P90 or something, but don't die to the MP7 that's giving him so much money every kill.
These SMGs are just changing so much up here. The CT side now pretty much going to be fairly well buffered for cash. They're 9-9 now. Titan have made no impact in those first three rounds in the second half. Not been able to do much with those pistols off the way that went down, but how can they recover from this? We're going to see them going in with what they can. No AWP for Kenny, of course. So it's going to be a bit of a struggle here, but a different start. Zipnik's pretty much soloing. Akadian's pretty close on short. He was playing here before, but Kerrigan going to be supporting on it, but seems to be pushing himself up towards A a little late. Actually opting for a scout.
Very patient play coming out here from Titan. In fact, they're waiting for TSM to try and gather some info right now. They're waiting for that peek, and they aren't being given it, right? Given it. TSM also playing very careful, patience, yes. So now it's who's going to crack first, essentially. Who's going to take that risk, try and get the info, or try and find the opening? And who's going to get the punish? And it looks like we're going to have a bit of a double boost coming up here into mid, maybe a triple even. They're going to try and rush out, take control of mid. Really well done here. Now do they go for the B split? It looks like it. RPK is already in position, but a fresh smoke has gone down to block in the B entrance. So Cajun, he might have what it takes. He needs to play this carefully, and he is going to make it out alive. In fact, there's two guys here to hold solid, and Dupree with that rifle. Kadian sits down. He's not able to take out RPK, though. Dupree with three, though. That's going to make a difference. Maybe a quad runs out of bullets. That's just unfortunate.
So close. Now, Maniac, 5 HP. Surely this round is just a little too far away from him. Bomb is right in the eyes of the DT players. A little low on the side there. As you said, Dupree pretty down to 23 HP in 10 seconds remaining. Maniac's making a play out of this. Carrigan needs to land one shot, one bullet. Oh, he just moved away in time. And Maniac gets the play.
Run
He's
away.
Going to take down Dupree. Time. Time is with the CTs. Carrigan looking for the pickup. And oh, that was a little close, but it gets dangerous in those situations. Finally, it I don't know. This is just terrifying to watch. It seems so close from start to finish. Great work on the site. As you mentioned, just running out bullets instead of being able to pick that kill up.
That's so frustrating as well when you have that M41. You have him dead to rights and you just click on empty. Ah,
the life of the silenced rifle, dude.
Yeah, there you go. That's a risky run. If you want to be invisible, you want to play with pew-pew lasers, well, sometimes you'll have that happen to you. And that's just the reality. You know, Sipmix, he likes being loud and proud. He just goes for the M4A4.
Oh, the shot's howling away towards A main. And
such a sick skin.
It looks beautiful, right? Four players now lining up. We've got Sipmix down, going to be smoked and flashed out, forcing towards quad. And the T-side going to start falling through towards side, just going to be working up by Forklift. Kadian does find one. We're going to see Carrigan pushing in and Kadian getting the double, but Titan do finally break through. They do have head armor. They got the Tech-9s. They got guns now to make this one a real damn battle. Dupree and Sipmix, they've got the work on their hands.
Yeah, they've got the crossfire as well. 55 seconds, though. This is a bit of time here for Maniac to work with, and they decide to challenge him. And Sipmix will win that duel, but he nearly goes down. Lives with 8 HP. That's a confidence play through and through, but a wild one, because you turn that into a 1v1, and anything can happen at that point. So really close call there. TSM just eking out the win, and you can see Maniac how frustrated he is with that result. He knows, if I could have just landed one more bullet on that guy, I could have won that round for my team.
The entire situation could have changed, but still. I think this is a time for talk more than anything. Existence is still in spawn. Kenny, Maniac, Apex, and RPK just kind of spreading throughout the map. Nothing really given so far. It's Existence just chilling out, it seems. Maybe discussing things for the upcoming rounds. You saw the frustration on Maniac's face in those last prior couple of rounds when they decided to make those plays towards A when the situation was close and that's starting to burn a little. So gets himself out there dancing away, but 1 minute left on this. The Tech-9s can just be as powerful when you just charge into a site, which I can imagine they're going to start going for pretty soon. But all in all, TSM, 11-9 up. This is worrying for Titan, and this doesn't look like a round they're going to get either.
Well, this is definitely looking like it should be another TSM round. They have everything that they need here. Titans still have the flashes, though. Smoke is going to go down to block off CT, the position that Sipmix is holding right now. So he's going to get smoked out. Has to change it up, and there's the rush. Titan just gonna go rushing onto this site. Sipmix takes out the first one, however, even despite being flashed from on high, though, Kenny just drops down, takes his face off, and Kenny with the second kill, and guess what? Kenny's got an op now. Are you really gonna try and challenge him? Yeah, that's what happens. Cajun does not win this time, but Apex has been taken out in the meantime, so it is Kenny in a 1v2, and he's stuck in a crossfire. Cajun holding this line, and now we get to see, how does Kenny S make this work? He goes for the pop flash, and he's actually going to make it. And he's going to stick the bomb plant as well. This is perfect play here from Kenny. I mean, what can he really do? The best case scenario at that point, unless he can... And he actually, that's really interesting. Kenny, that could also be just, you know, if you really want to nitpick, if you want to look into it, you know, feels like Kenny, 3 weeks ago before the update, he would have gone for the win instead of the safe play, which is to make the money for your team. If you lose the round, you get the bomb plant, you get a bonus $800 for everybody, which can go into a near full set of nades. I feel like, you know, 3 weeks ago, we would have seen Kenny just take that fight and try and turn it into a 1v1 because he had a few seconds.
He did. Everything was working well. And the double AWP now coming out for the CTs. If it was going to be a time to really add insult to injury, it would have been then. But denying Cajun B this time, winning out in that battle. But Dupree, perfect flash over the top, allows him to beat down Apex, but doesn't have the time for RPK. Gets overwhelmed. And it looks like the B side should be in control of the T side as... Yeah, Carrigan didn't have a time to get there. Carrigan does have a glimpse, though. The smoke not quite covering it. Now Kenny might have to do the deed again.
Kadian might have heard the steps there on A. He might be calling this out. He should be calling this out to his mates. I'm not sure if he was close enough to hear Maniac running. Maniac just ran through, and he's going to completely flank out Carrigan. Sipmix now has to worry about getting flanked as well. He's in position, and Maniac checks the angle, and this time Maniac wins. 5 HP left on him, but that's perfectly fine. He's still a live body. That's all Titan care about at this point, because now it's all pressure on Kadian, and is he really going to be going for this? Right now, the money is actually pretty close, and it is not going to work out for Kadian. He takes the risk, and it does not pay off. A fantastic round for Titan to get right back into this. And we can see now it's a bit of a seesaw situation for TSM. Up and down, up and down. They really are in a bit of a mixed position. So they could go for an eco round right now, but what they should do is invest in like Kevlar 5.7 on the guys who have a lot of money, and then just leave it for the rest of them. Maybe drop them P250s or something. And instead, they're going to skimp. They're going to let Sipnix and Kerrigan sweat.
Cruelty at its finest. I do see, as you said, you know, a couple of P250s, a 5.7 in there, but no armor, no nothing shed out. So I'm curious to see what they're going for here. Maybe feeling confident just later on and didn't feel the need to put the pressure into this round. But T-Sard taking this just as heftily as every other. Not rushing, not going to push too quick. Kenny taking it real slow there. You saw him starting to find that little bit of form. That opening shot doing marvelously. Wish we could have seen what have happened with Carragher, but Maniac's positioning in that last round was perfect, going around the backside and just kind of finding the loophole.
I think that's also just timing, right? Lady Luck not really giving the wink Cadian's way that time, because I thought he was just on the edge of hearing Maniac run. He would have been in A halls. He might have heard the steps. He might not. There it is. Because if he can tell you guys are getting flanked, Kerrigan whips around and takes Maniac out, and that should be an easy kill for him. Didn't play out that way. Instead, we're going to have this kind of quasi-eco buy coming in from TSM, and Titan looking to go crashing into this A site. They are getting flanked out by Kerrigan, but Apex is making sure that this isn't going to work for him. And I don't think he heard the steps of Kerrigan either. Kerrigan could come right in from Squeak and maybe get a free kill here. Apex and Existence very low. Existence the one planting the bomb. Nobody watching this angle. He could get it for free. Does he take the shot? What?
Oh,
what?
What?
Existence, you gentlemen, you closed the door behind you. What are you doing? Oh, that's so sad for Kerrigan. Oh, now they know. And he still gets the headshot. He gets the double. Is he going to do it again? No, they're too close to the site. They're too close to the site. I was having flashbacks to Nuke versus Nip when Kerrigan pulled that real play, got two impossible kills, and then like clutch defuses the bomb with a split second left.
And let's just watch this back. The moment after it was sublime. He was like so ready to get into that then. He was like, okay, I'm just gonna, oh wait. Brilliant, brilliant stuff. 12-11 is the scoreline. TSM still maintain the lead by a very small margin. Buy up coming in for the CT side, not an ideal one by any margin. A couple of Famuses in there, Cajun B and Zimnix gonna be sticking on towards those. Kerrigan does get the AWP this time, so taking that over Cajun B this, and I think we might be able to see why.
And I overheard Kerrigan earlier, you know, the AWP change for him, he is definitely not miffed about it because it favors his style. He's fine with just holding an angle, taking a shot, changing up the angle, taking another shot, falling back consistently, right? So Kerrigan, he's perfectly content to just sit here and wait for somebody to walk into his crosshair. Kenny this time around is not going to give him the opportunity for a duel. He decides to change up his position, which is what he should be doing as well. If he doesn't have any luck here, spend 10 seconds holding this angle. Okay, go change it up to another angle and see what you can find.
Systematically making the way through the map. It looks like the CT side going to be heading out towards A. We still got three players there, Kerrigan, Zipnix, and Cadian. You can see the boost forming through mid. Dupree and Cajun B still sticking on towards that B side, but Kerrigan has been holding this angle. He's going to be locking this one down. Is he going to go start looking? He's going to start hunting. He might just catch a glimpse. I think he's just saw Kenny S's head just over the box. Going to try and pop flash out. Doesn't get the ideal, but through the wall! That should not be possible. That's unreal from Kenny. Just knowing where Kerrigan was going to back to and making the most out of that. Four standing now for CT side. They should be in ruins, and they're going B.
Yeah, talk about the fake. Talk about the total fake. Maniac still waiting. He's going to find the headshot on Cadian. Not going to win the duel versus Sipnix. But it's still, the damage is done. 2-on-3 retake scenario. They have no kit. They have no gear. This is basically TSM. They're going to run around here, pick up the guns, and look to save. So the AWP for Kerrigan will get picked up, as well as an M4 for Sipnix. But you got to give it to Kenny. I've seen a lot of players go for that wallbang. Haven't seen it with an AWP, and I've never seen a kill actually come from it. So that
not
is so
that
sick.
From that side, like you occasionally maybe see it from, you know, the truck.
Yes,
like,
yes. Go ahead.
Yeah, dude. Someone please make it happen. But
don't do it. Don't do it. We'll take commends, but not the other way around.
I've just got to say, Kenny doing that. That's one knowing where the only options for Kerrigan was going to go. Don't get me wrong. There's luck in that, you know. There is a lot of luck in that. That he was lined up perfectly. I think that's even a headshot as well.
Yeah,
connect
through. Just dead on.
That's a small pixel to be hitting, but perfect, absolutely perfect way to get this one going, and then faking it out regardless, hitting up that B side no matter what.
What's really wild for me is Maniac, just in this lurk role. On CT side, he's been doing very well, but in the lurk role, he's been excelling as well. He's just picking up these kills. And these can be like a combination, you know, like high impact kills, right? Because he takes out the man on short, and that pretty much eliminates any option for TSM to attempt a retake, you know, losing that one guy. So Maniac, he's getting the job done. He's nearly dropping a 30 bomb right now, which is sick considering just not so long ago, he was really struggling with his personal performance and with the criticism he was receiving because of it.
So Cajun. And RPK finding form is going to just make it worse. Cajun being Dupree going down. RPK just solid. That's all you can say about this guy. Doesn't need to be outstanding all the time, but just every time you need someone to find that comfort zone, he is there. Apex going to just deny Carrigan a chance, and now Zipnix and Kadian a mile away from this one. They might be able to get down Maniac. Maybe, no. Anyway, finding Zipnix and Kadian pretty much out of this one. I doubt he's going to have time to get around to him.
This is where you can actually kind of have some trouble as far as, you know, having a stand-in. Like, yep. T-side, you can allow for, I mean, maybe, you know, some flashes, some smokes aren't going to be the same because Kadian may not know how to throw them. But on CT side, you know, a lot of it comes down to communication, knowing the rotations, etc. You can try and plop a guy down in a position and he can come through big. But right now it is, I mean, he is also, you know, second on the board right now for TSM. So, I mean, it's not like Kadian isn't getting frags, but it could be throwing TSM off just a little bit, enough for Titan to take advantage of it.
And I would love to know after this game, you know, whoever wins, loses, just to find out how much that played into Titan's mindset as well. Like, how can we maybe, you know, punish these guys for this? At least Kadian will get a gun out of it, though. So if he can keep hold of this, it's not the end of the world. But we knew that Maniac was close by regardless, and Kenny is going to be closing in. These guys systematically looking through the map, and Maniac's starting to think, maybe he got behind me here. Oh, okay, let me go and check back right now. And actually going to use a flash to get into this one. It does flash Kadian up, and Maniac will take him down. That just pure awareness, just systematically closing off the map one by one and then just working out that's where he can be. But RPK, that's it. You know, this guy is getting back into it, considering he was such a new player coming back into the scene. You know, it was such a long break and then such a short time finding some real comfort. But 13-12 now, Titan taking back the lead.
Yeah, RPK is, you know, he's got the aim. Like, that is no, there's nothing there. He's got the aim. It really does seem like he still has to get just used to the movement, the mechanics. Some of the mechanics of the game aren't quite sticking yet, and that'll just come with time. But he's already shown us that, you know, that aim that he was legendary for back in Source, yeah, he's still got a bit of it. So, you know, don't go toe-to-toe. Those positions on B, for example, you can excel in, because it really is just stand there, line up your crosshair, pull the trigger, and you're going to get kills. And that's where RPK can just be the tank. You know, you just, you hear the gears whirring, the treads clinking, and then all of a sudden he's just rolling over you.
Yeah, the Yadpa Panther coming in from RPK, but still, this time Kadian going to get a little confident there, go for a nice little peek towards Maniac, up on towards Red Container on site, but taking Maniac down, he's been lurking over towards A the entire time. It's not showing too much, but Cajun B spotting out Kenny, not going to take the shot just yet, waits for it, and actually gave him a chance to get a shot through, but did take him down. So one by one, Titan is starting to fall, and Cajun B backing out in time, 62 HP, and RPK being held off. So nicely timed out there on B for the TSM side.
That was really nicely done there by Titan as well. Apex is going to go leaping into Kadian, who just happens to be in the right place at the right time to stop that push coming in. And Kadian peeks out and just annihilates Existence. So that bomb is dropped all the way back in the middle of Africa. RPK now, he's just stuck. He's going to get spotted out by Dupree, who's holding this B site. He hasn't seen too much action either, Dupree, apart from just like playing the rotator. Haven't really come to B site too often, Titan, so Dupree, I'm sure, is itching for some more action over there. But you gotta give it to RPK and Existence, actually, because that was them trying to line it up. They realized, okay, wait, there's a guy up in vents, I've got a Molotov, and you can see that RPK is rotating into B halls to catch that guy as he comes out of the vents. Unfortunately for him, there was a smoke down blocking it. So he was in position for, that's the kind of teamwork that Titan are capable of, right? He was in position to play off of Existence's play, but he wasn't able to just because of that smoke. But, you know, A for effort, right?
And I love even on the other side of things, I think it was Dupree who actually flashed out to slow down anyone possibly coming through those B halls just to allow his teammate to get away from those vents. And it was just good synergy on both sides. Mm-hmm. Really nicely done. 13-13 now, all even, all square, back into the buy here. We do see Apex going down a little early in this, so losing such an impactful player. He's going to put Kenny in the crosshairs, hopefully going to be landing some. Missing two. That's not something I'm used to seeing, especially when he's going to have them literally challenging him down. That's very confident from TSM to even take that sort of exchange, but it worked off. RPK and Maniac now pretty much locked out. This Maniac did get towards A, but, you know, RPK. Did he just try and, like, hit him with...
Oh, that's so unfortunate for RPK.
Did he find out where he was by throwing that then?
That's just bad luck, bad timing. Kadian re-smoking and RPK literally running into that smoke so that he gets blocked on the edge of the smoke. So he's blind, but TSM see him. It's just, that's just so awkward. That's just so awkward. But what's really awkward here is that Titan are now allowing TSM to get back into this. TSM, they're up at 14 rounds. They've got a little bit of a bank to work with. Whereas Titan, this is it. This is the end all be all. This round has to be won by them, because otherwise they're going to be in a force buy awkward situation in the next one. So they have to do the damage here. They have to get something done while they have the rifles. And Maniac, well, I you have to understand why Sipnix is doing this. It's because Maniac has been in Squeak Door every single round.
You said it. A player like Maniac likes his routes. He likes his positions. He plays this way. And when people start working that out, if he doesn't adjust a touch, he can be called out. And already, for absolutely nothing gifted from TSM, he gets taken down half HP. But Kenny starts looking.
Oh, Kadian.
Oh my god, Kadian.
Oh, they're right on
you
the edge.
I don't know what you are getting into here, Kadian. One step to the left. He could be done for, just trying to avoid it. Maybe he's keeping this in the back of his mind, but doesn't matter. Apex pushes forward. And maybe this is going to be the play coming out from the T side. They're starting to swarm towards A. The CT side doing the same. I'm waiting to see them commit here, though.
Kadian trying to force the issue. And that was, he just stayed a little bit too long. He needed to back off there. So him getting caught out, that's not going to help things here for TSM. Apex going for the counter boost. This is fantastic. Think he got spotted, though. And Kerrigan takes out Maniac, who was indoors. But there's Kenny taking Kerrigan out of the heavens. And it's going to be Sipnix behind quad boxes. Takes the fight and wins it versus Apex. Now he just needs to dance. Are they friends? Is that what's going to happen here? Existence just holding this angle, and there's the Molotov. It's going to force the issue, and Existence will be waiting for him. RPK takes out Dupree, and it's down to Cajun B. But it is not going to happen. Kenny finds him, and we are in that 14-14 scenario here. This is actually going to be, well, just TSM having enough money to buy. So it's not quite as dire for them, but it is so close between both of these teams. We're getting the full 30 rounds, Pansy.
Oh, we are. At the start, I thought this was going to be a little bit defined one way or the other, you know, a little bit more clear cut. But these two, not satisfied with that. They want the back and forth. They want that standoff in every single round. And well, it's just brilliant to watch. Kerrigan, confident through mid, going to be pushing up pretty darn aggressively. I don't think I've seen him do that just yet. And Zipnix again. Maniac getting tagged up again, not quite as severely, but still, for absolutely nothing. Kadian got a little tagged himself, but it's not the end of one. Cajun B actually has zero armor to be working with this time. So looking at it this way, where do we see the T side going? They're not getting these opening picks so clearly.
I'm really glad that Kerrigan is in the position that he's in right now. He's the information man for his team right now. Flash over, Kenny might get aggressive. He might try and peek forward, and Kerrigan, they haven't really done this. They haven't really held close to boost so much TSM. So this could catch Kenny off guard, potentially. This is all about Kerrigan now just setting up, going for that element of surprise. He is alone in his element right now. He has set his team up, however, to hold off an A push. So if this does come through, he could get the info and set it up. Titan, where do they decide to take this?
Kenny's got a bomb. They're looking like they're going towards B, but Kerrigan finding Existence then. They drop the bomb off, the flash comes out. It's gonna slow them down. I think that's from Dupree. He's buying time and the rotate's coming through. Kerrigan is in vents. Pressure from the back, but two in the front. Spins around, doesn't get Apex down though, leaving just Cajun B and Dupree standing. It looks like Titans surely are gonna get themselves onto this. But it's a race towards A, and Cajun B is running the right way.
He's running the right way. He's got the AWP as well. He can hold this angle, and they almost line up, but he misses the shot. He misses the shot, and that is just muscle memory right there. That is muscle memory that comes back to bite him. He was definitely expecting to get around that corner to land that. And now, I mean, now, basically, Titan, all they have to do is hold. They don't have to peek, and they are going to be forced to back off because TSM are broke. They need both of these guns to take it to overtime in the next round. But I can assure you that Cajun is pissed after that shot because I'm pretty sure in his mind's eye and in his hands, basically, he was feeling that shot was going to be dead on, and he was going to save the round for his team.
Let's be honest, if he just got that bomb plant down, or the one guy with the bomb, if he'd just been able to stop him, that would have been it. There was like 8 seconds left. If that, he could have pressured just enough, but it wasn't to be, and it will be Titan to claim that round out, and my god, a well-needed one. 15-14, this is kind of on to finish the way the previous one did, and look at this. Just a touch too early, almost.
It's moving. He's just, yeah, look, he puts it in the wall, and he expects to be just that centimeter past, and they almost lined up as well. He could have had a two for one. Like, that could have been just magical.
My heart was thinking, I was like, John, this could happen. But still, we are seeing what TSM can forge together now. Katie again taken very low quite early on there. 79 HP, not drastically, don't only have that 5-7, as does Zipnix. So two very key players here going to have to play slightly different. Maniac this time will get away scot-free. No one going to be spamming that door with that howl. So, all in all, Dupree, Cajun B, and Kerrigan, the only ones with guns here, going to have to do some real big play.
Okay. Maniac waiting in Squeak. Sip gets flashed, but he's not going to jump in. I would really actually love to see Cajun take the AWP over behind quad boxes there and just start wall-banging into Squeak Room. If Maniac is there every time, Sipnix going through the door is fun and all, but time to bring out the big guns. Instead, it's going to be a full-out smoke flash round and Molotov round onto the site, and Dupree nearly burns alive.
That floor was like lava. Dupree needs to get rid of that gun. He can do so little with it now. Surely Zivnik's going to pick that one up, and Dupree's going to switch it out. The AXU looking like it's coming out from the T side, but will they commit? Zivnik's finding Apex. That is a dire beginning. 39 seconds now. RPK is out with the bomb. He is carrying this one, but can he close out there? And they just hit to the left, and that could be a disaster. But Zivnik's again. Maniac goes down. RPK still fighting, finds one, but Dupree kicks into gear. This looks like we're going to overtime. Dupree coming up big. 2-2. Zivnik's and Dupree, the dastardly duo doing damage, and now one man left in this existence gets down Carrigan, but 3-5.
Yeah, 3-5. KGB holding that angle, and he is not going to miss that shot this time. And we will have overtime. Titan just not able to make it through the smokes, through the fire, and TSM on point with the hold. Zivnik's in particular, he was actually watching over that smoke for that boost that Apex had used several rounds ago as well. So they learned that Apex was doing that, and it looks like Zivnik's was prepared this time. No success there for Apex. Zivnik's really stepping up big for his team in that round. And Dupree as well with 2 kills of his own. But I'd say that the M4 kills, nearly more important, but really just solid work on that A side for TSM.
And considering Dupree had switched Zivnik's that gun earlier on, he was like, you don't take this, I took too much damage.
That's insane.
You think back in your mind, that one nade that came from RPK that just clipped off the left side of that box,
that could have killed Dupree.
Tucked around towards quad, that's a player who got 2 kills out of the game. That's a different situation altogether. These small things, these small, tiny things can just affect so much into this. As we wait for overtime, I'm so glad we're getting this game because, you know, I was excited for like a 16-14 scoreline, let alone overtime, and we're getting that, so but I don't know what to expect.
Yeah, exactly. What do you think, Panzer? We're going to get 19-15 now? Is it going to go perfect now that one team is going to be able to reset over the other? I mean, we're talking about two teams who have nearly forgotten how to close games as well. I mean, TSM, it's been the epic struggle. How do you close a map? And Titan, it's the same thing. I'd almost go so far as to say that Titan have forgotten how to win. And they need to relearn the entire process. So their inability to close out a game where they have the firepower gear advantage, allowing it to go to overtime, you know, that's a symptom of, you know, Titan still struggling to close out a map. So we could go 30 rounds every map between these two.
Quite easily, and so many times one of these two teams at, you know, several different points would have had the opportunity to close, you know, every single time. You know, there was those moments where Titan had that advantage, they had the money, they had everything building, and then it slipped. Same with TSM, on occasion they've had that moment and it's just kind of trickled away from them. But I don't know why, but I feel more confident in TSM, and I don't feel I should almost. It's like I feel wrong to be saying that just because
they did well at Star Series, they did well at Copenhagen Games. I suppose you could go off of that, right? Recent performance.
For sure. But it's like, I shouldn't be backing a team that has a stand-in over one that's a solid lineup, right? With Kenny S of all players, but then, you know, okay, you've got the update coming into practice, you've got these guys, you know, back and forth, they played each other recently, they're in each other's heads, but I've got to say, I'm going for TSM in this. I feel as though they've just shown that they have that grit to pull through, and that final round just proving to me they didn't even have what they wanted ideally, and they still made it work. But let's see what they can do now they have everything they need. Double up, AWP coming up to play for the CT side, if I can use my words. And the T side just going to be straight into this fully brought up, looking beautiful, looking comfortable. And this is just that kind of nice, even kill to begin on. I don't know what to make of it.
Well, I'll tell you what needs to happen here. TSM need to win this round because they just invested in a double AWP on the first round. A lot of gear already used as well in the smokes and nades, but this is so expensive, and this is MR310K, so CT side struggles if they don't pick up the first round, because then it's so difficult for them to keep buying in the rounds that follow. They'll have another full buy, but if they lose that one, then they're on a force buy for the last round, and it gets really hard to get that one round on the board or two that you might need. So TSM, double up right out the gates. They have to hit some shots. Carrigan, you have to come in big here. You're holding a main. You cannot get out-peaked.
And I can't wait for this. Maniac is starting to lurk around as well. He's starting to look for this. He was going through Squeaky the whole time during that standard round. Switching up now. Titan taking control over mid. They've got Kenny. They've got Apex and Existence all there. Maniac starts to back away. Kenny showing that power he has. Taking down Carrigan, the man you highlighted, had to hit those shots. Just gets whipped down.
Man, that's a shadow of you know, Kenny's former glory, Existence. Takes out Dupree, who was going into checkered. Division B, however, is rotated over, and he puts a shot into the wall and gets the follow-up missed. Can he hit this one? Yes, he does. Drops the bomb carrier. Existence goes across, though. Cajun D spotted that, so he can communicate that to his team. And unfortunately, Cajun can't land the shot on Existence, who will proceed to get a safe plant all the way in the back corner. And this is TSM. Look, TSM, they know now. And what's worse is that they've lost both AWPs, unless they can go back and pick up Carrigan. Actually, they can save one. Cajun can go back to quad boxes and pick up Kerrigan's op. So they will be able to save one AWP here, which is so important for them. But go with...
Get the AWP.
go and...
Where is 40, it? Sure, it was a quad, right?
It's $47.50, guys. You really need that money. Like, you really need that. That gun right there, it's really important that you pick it up.
Gideon. Maybe just trying to wait.
I like YNK's like almost like, trying to convince
come on,
him.
Dude.
Like
this is yours.
This is like a dog with a ball, right? You know, he's just looking at the ball, like throw the ball, throw the ball. Are you gonna throw it? You gonna throw it? And I guess no. I guess TSM are not gonna pick up that AWP. So they want to spend more of their money, or they want to go for straight rifles, and they aren't feeling confident in the op. So that could be it as well. But no, but then Kerrigan buys an op again. So I mean,
is that, I don't know if that's miscommunication, too focused onto another topic to not be like, hey, we're,
it could be miscommunication, perhaps, or just, Kerrigan could think that, you know, something has happened there, or they're just playing really safe and they don't want to throw away a rifle that they have. But I would say that considering they lost the first round of CT, it's almost worth the risk to go and pick up that AWP, because buying an M4, yeah, that's fine, but AWPs are very expensive. They nearly cost half of the money that you start off the halftime with.
Yeah, they don't come cheap in this one. And looking at the way the T-side played that out, Titan just took control of mid, and then Kenny's opener, just beautiful. And again, this guy finding form in overtime of all things, that's just going to throw TSM off. He was, I wouldn't say average. Average is a bad thing. He was looking then, just down below.
For some reason.
Just waiting. Just, hello?
I saw like Kenny just doing a happy dance there, where he's just going back and forth, back and forth. He's like, I can peek, I can peek. It's coming back to me, guys. It's coming back. Kenny, the God Opper, he's on the map. He's created two opportunities for his team now. We have to see more. They're looking like they could potentially split A, although Cajun B peeks out from Vents, could get a double here, and he will.
Huge round coming in. Kadian finally gets a little bit of something going for himself. Apex going down. Bomb is lost in mid. They know it. RPK and Maniac, the two players have been focused towards the remaining sites, and they'll know that. They know Maniac will be over by A. He's been there the vast majority of the time. Gonna get running, gonna have to pick up that bomb. 28 seconds and four players to find. I gotta say, Cajun B, the man who started off phenomenally in this one, has just found another brilliant moment, and Zipnik's not going to let him near that bomb. Denies it, and that is a big round coming for TSM. Bring it back to 16-16.
Yeah, Zipnik's has been stepping up individually as well for TSM. Oh, yeah. For a while, he was in a bit of a slump, not quite able to pull in those big key clutch rounds or getting those key kills in a round. And it's been quite some time now that we've seen him really being able to start racking up some headshots of his own on top of Cajun B, who yeah, he did start off strong, but then kind of petered out towards the end of the first map.
Kadian actually sticking with the AWP this time as well, over Kerrigan.
Kadian can AWP, Kadian.
Yeah, he said even before, he was like, you know, I started to dabble with it a couple of times on the T side, and now I'll pick it up on the CT side into this one. So maybe being trusted with that Kerrigan, maybe thinking, I don't need it, don't want it. NES though, don't challenge this man. Doesn't make the shot count, but they know what's going on. They're starting to head towards A. Kenny, don't go for that wall back again, it'll just scare me. Gonna be peeking over, looking for these standard spots. And I love Kenny, he's so clinical with the way he works it, but then just the flair that he finishes these rounds off with sometimes.
He's like the mad scientist, you know? He will be very clinical, and then all of a sudden he has this stroke of inspiration, and yeah, and then he's like, I'm going to give it four limbs, and five on top of that. And it's just like craziness that comes out. And he's not afraid of fire either, because he knows how to treat burns, obviously. So, let's see. Already, Titan, they're going for the full-on Molo run onto the A site, and it's working out brilliantly. Although the double spray down from Kerrigan does not happen. Apex is going to pick up two headshots here. And this is now looking like Titan have control of this situation. They should be able to lock the round down from here on out.
Sublime little flash there from Apex, and look at the boost up. This could be trouble, but Cajun be actually stopping the box. Oh, Cajun! Again, what presence in this game he's had, but now 1v2. Cadian gonna push in aggressively with that 5-7. He's got a player literally behind him. Maniac is behind him right now, and Maniac surely to close this. Well played out by Titan to just deny that threat, because as soon as Cajun B started to get those kills, you can't deny that, man. That guy can turn anything.
They had better have won that round right there, Titan, because for Titan to make such a colossal mistake to not cover their bomb planter, that would have been, if they, you know, like basically Maniac just flips the table at that point if that happens. Because RPK, he's planting that bomb because he thinks, okay, you know, I've got cover,
I'm in the safe
plant, and somebody's definitely watching my back, right? Guys? Anyone? Oh, wait, there's Cajun. This sucks. Like, that was a big mistake there made by Titan. So luckily for them, Maniac was able to turn it around with a double kill.
Because the funny thing was, Apex's flash was perfect, though. It was, you know, it was timed well, but the time it took him then to get up onto the boost and just peek over that quad box, they were already up on the side. That's what KGB was. So it was just like, they took the confidence, they knew they could just push through that. And well, we are now seeing the scoreline, 17-16, TSM back by one round, but Titan struggled a little on the CT side towards the start, but then found their form later on. But this is the full end by round. This is everything they wanted. And look at this play from TSM. That's decisive. That's the first big play we're going to see coming out. A real standard bang up A push. And Cajun B finding Kenny S going to give this site over surely to TSM. But no, Apex finds one, but it's not enough.
Yeah, good clear there by Kerrigan looking up high. But then Maniac, there was a triple stack initially, guys. Maniac, he's racking up frags, and he's still alive behind quad boxes. This is so important now. He's got the bomb in front of him. Kerrigan's going to walk in. He's very low, and Kerrigan doesn't secure the kill. This is far too close now. Maniac playing this perfectly. Existence is there to support now as well, and Cajun's going to get cleaned up by RPK at range. Talk about instant reflexes from Maniac. Was it Sixth Sense, or did he just barely start to hear the steps coming through A main for him to abort on the boot and on the boost and just jump down onto that site? It didn't look like TSM spotted him either. So TSM messing up the count, not realizing that was, well, I mean, it just happened to work. Titan had three guys on A site. That saved them, literally saved them that round.
Maniac, what a huge play he's had in this game. 35 kills, including overtime, of course. But that round, the kills he got, regardless of the amount, changed everything. 18-16 now, TSM need this, and Cajun B again getting the opener. Apex goes down, Kinnis fancies the challenge, not gonna get it though. Cajun B gets tagged and gets away. So, you know, a little bit of a good gain there for TSM, but not really opening up either of the sides. Still kind of two players around it. Kenny gonna be, you know, rotating in between, but he can kind of leave Maniac just to, you know, sit there up on that boost. Something you mentioned first of all, and if they go away and they don't check that, it would blow my mind.
Just go up short. It's like the hard counter every single time. If you get the mid control, you smoke out connector, and then you just walk up short, and Maniac is hung out to dry. Like a very nice shirt on a line on a windy day. And now this is going to be the B push, and RPK, they're just going to go crashing in.
RPK just moved off site. He's just left Existence there. The smoke, the flashes coming into play, and nice work from Existence slowing them down, but they're on the site, they're at the doorstep, but Existence knocks back one, but it's Dupree, and Dupree has his day, picking up the double as Kenny finds a touch through the smoke, maybe to push in towards, but baited out by it, and the bomb does go down. Zimnik still lurking in the background. Maniac might be caught off by this as well. Oh, he's going to pop flash through. I think he knows what's up here. Checking the corner. Nicely done from Maniac. But now, Kenny S and Maniac have a lot of work to still do.
They do. And I almost want to see Kenny change it up for an M4 if he can find one. But Cajun is going to catch him lurking in CT, and Cajun holding checkered halls. And that was the Triangle of Doom, the full power of it. Pythorgus would be proud. I mean, that was wild. TSM locking that down. Now they are within striking distance, and it's going to be Titan who are hard-pressed. Very hard-pressed indeed to hold, because the state of the economy, they do manage to get three rifles in an op, but that's at the cost of a rifle for Apex. He has to go CZ.
Yeah, and the double op setup now coming up for TSM, so feeling they want to start that one up. And Cajun B, the man who made so much work happen, peeking down Kenny S in mid. This time adjusting round, Cadian as well picking up the op. So, maybe feeling confident with that, feeling like he can be the man to close this one down, take it a double overtime here between TSM and Titan. Remember, this is the semi-finals, and Kenny getting a nice little boost there, going to be able to peek across from quad box, Apex being the stepping stone for him. And with 1 minute left, it looks like T-Side going to start up weighing their options, but not actually committing towards the nade. Oh, that's beautiful. Just fighting Apex and Kenny, that's a 2-for-1 that he didn't expect.
Ouch, ouch, ouch. That's very painful. And that's on Apex as well, as if this, you know, this guy had it rough enough. Although he is probably one of the best CZ players in the game right now. He's able to use it long range, close range, spray, tap. Like, Apex is really showing that the CZ, he's put a lot of work into that gun for quite some time. So I'd almost say, like, he might as well have a rifle in his hands with how effective he can be. RPK is going to get the headshot onto Dupree. And TSM, they're trying to push forward. Kerrigan actually YOLOing into Checkered with the bomb. Really scary stuff. They are going to be committed to this site if he dies at this point.
And they're being held up. Everyone across the map, we're going to see time starting to come into play. And look at the time. As you point out, 20 seconds remain. They do not have much time to work with. Flash by flash, Titan taking the advantage. Zipnik, Cadian trying to hold on, but Apex round the back, you pointed him out, doesn't get the follow-up kill. And Titan goes it out with RPK being the man to stop it where it started. 19-17 as a closing scoreline.